गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू सोशल साइंस ऑनलाइन टीचिंग क्लासेस फ्रॉम विश्व मानव रेसिडेंशियल हाई स्कूल। आई एम महबूबी, यूर सोशल साइंस टीचर। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट कंटिन्यू पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन, दैट इज लेबर। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास यू हैव लर्न 1 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स एंड 2 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स। नाउ लेट्स टुडे स्टडी अबाउट 3 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स इन द लेसन लेबर। ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स क्रिएटिंग इनइक्वालिटी इन लेबर इन इंडिया, और व्हाट आर द रीजंस फॉर इनइक्वालिटी इन लेबर इन इंडिया। व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स? वन इज क्लास, सेकेंड वन इज इनकम, थर्ड वन इज जेंडर, फोर्थ वन इज रीजन, फिफ्थ वन इज कैस्ट एंड सिक्स्थ वन इज रिलीजन। दीज आर द इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्टर्स क्रिएटिंग इनइक्वालिटी इन इंडिया इन लेबर। ओके, देन सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन लेबर, और एक्सप्लेन द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन लेबर इन इंडिया। What are the discrimination in labor? Answer: In our country, men are paid more for their work than women. All of you know that men are paid more for their work than women. Even though such a discrimination is less in government sector. In agriculture sector, unequal division of labor is based on sex, age, and capacities. Again, there is a lot of discrimination between educated and uneducated peoples. In the lot of discrimination between educated and uneducated peoples, then after there is a lot of discrimination in private sector is also. The inequality is based on gender, class, income, region and religion. These are the discrimination in labor in India. Then second, third question, labor without pay is different than labor with pay, how? Or what are the difference between labor without pay and labor with pay? Dear students, one side labor without pay and another side labor with pay. First we shall going to discuss labor without pay. In the labor without pay, we can see work is done without payment either in cash or kind. Then second point, labor without pay, it is a payless worker, it is a payless work. Then third point, the best example of the labor without pay, that is family. In family, mother or housewife, that is the best example of the labor without pay. Then second point, labor with pay. In the labor with pay, we can see the labor which gets compensation based on hours, based on days and based on months. Then second point, in the labor with pay, we can see wages are given based on hours, days, weeks or months. And the third point, in the labor with pay, that is labor in small business. It is a small business and roadside business. In the roadside business, it is a small business, work in factories, building work, agriculture farm works can be grouped under labor with pay. These are the difference between labor with pay and labor without pay. Then fourth question, what are the main features of organized laborers, or what are the facilities available for organized laborers, or explain the characteristics of organized laborers? Dear students, first you can observe the question, what are the features or characteristics of organized labor sector? Dear students, answer, labor framework. Legal framework, second point, the main features of organized laborers, that is fixed work. Then third point, job security. Fourth point, fixed salary. Fifth point, social security. And the last point, employment guarantee. These are the main features of organized laborers. Then fifth question, what are the rules that should be followed to start the business in the organized sector? Dear students, first you can observe the question, what are the rules that should be followed to start the business in organized sector? First point, in any type of business, first you can take the permission of the government. Understand? Then second point, it is also mandatory. Mandatory means it is also compulsory for them to pay taxes. Then third point, it is the responsibility of the institution to pay special facilities. Then fourth point, provide employment securities for the workers. And the last point, provide pay on specified dates along with overtime. Whenever the workers have worked more than the time, these are the rules and regulations that should be followed to start in any type of business in the organized sector. And let's move on. Very important question. That is, list out the problems of unorganized laborers. Or, what are the problems faced by unorganized laborers? Or, unorganized workers are undergoing many problems. Why? Answer, no legal provisions, no job security, no fixed wages or and allowances. Then fourth point, no social security. Fifth point, no medical benefits. And last point, exploitation from owners. These are the problems of unorganized laborers. In the first term, in the unorganized laborers, we can see there is no legal provisions, there is no job security, there is no fixed wages, there is no fixed salary, there is no social security, there is no medical benefits and exploitation from owners. These are the problems faced by unorganized laborers. And seventh question, what are the challenges faced by unorganized laborers? Answer, migration. Second point, social security. Third point, legal framework. Fourth point, childhood. Then fourth point, child labor. And the last point, physical and mental exploitations. These are the challenges faced by unorganized laborers. And let's move on. The very important question in this lesson, that is, what are the difference between organized and unorganized laborers? Or how organized workers different from unorganized workers? Dear students, first we discussed organized laborers. First one is, there are government by special rules. In the organized sectors, in the organized laborers, we can see it is a government work. Understand? Then second point, they engage in fixed workers. Then third point, they have job security. And fourth point, they come under tax provisions. These are the organized laborers. It is a
गवर्नमेंट रूल्स. इन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबरर्स इट इज ए फिक्स्ड वर्क, इट इज ए फिक्स्ड सैलरी, इट इज ए सोशल सिक्योरिटी, इट इज ए जॉब सिक्योरिटी एंड दे कम अंडर टैक्स प्रोविजंस. देन सेकेंड पॉइंट, अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबरर्स. इन अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबरर्स और अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर वी कैन सी इट इज ए नॉन गवर्नमेंट. दे आर नॉट गवर्नमेंट बाय एनी स्पेशल रूल्स. देन दे आर एंगेज्ड इन मेनी वर्क्स. इन अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबर्स वी कैन सी दे आर एंगेज्ड इन मेनी वर्क्स. इन अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबरर्स वी कैन सी दे हैव नो जॉब सिक्योरिटी, दे हैव नो फिक्स्ड सैलरी, दे हैव नो सोशल सिक्योरिटी. देन द लास्ट पॉइंट, दे आर नॉट कम अंडर टैक्स प्रोविजंस. दीज आर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबरर्स एंड अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबरर्स. ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेसन वी हैव लर्न 1 marks क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स, 2 marks क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स एंड 3 marks क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स इन द लेसन लेबर. लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट द अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट चैप्टर इन दिस वीडियो, दैट इज इंडियन फिजियोग्राफी. इन ज्योग्राफी part 1 इंडियन फिजियोग्राफी. ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट. द लेसन इंडियन फिजियोग्राफी. इन दिस लेसन लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट 1 marks क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स, 2 marks क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स एंड 3 marks क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स. फर्स्ट स्टडी अबाउट 1 marks क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स इन द लेसन इंडियन फिजियोग्राफी. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाई इज द ग्रेटर हिमालयस कॉल्ड एज हिमाद्री. आंसर, द ग्रेटर हिमालयस आर कवर्ड विथ स्नो थ्रूट आउट द ईयर. ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट द ग्रेटर हिमालयस आर covered with snow throughout the year, so these ranges are called as Himadri. Then second question, which is the highest peak in the world? All of you know that Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. Keep it mind, very important question. Then third point, what are called as outer Himalayas? First you can observe the question. What are called as outer Himalayas? Answer, the outermost ranges are foothills located to the south of the main Himalayas are called as outer Himalayas. Then fourth question, which is the highest peak in India? K2. Answer, K2 or Godwin Einstein is the highest peak in India. Keep it mind, very important. K2 is the highest peak in India. Then fifth question, the Himalayas ranges causes heavy rainfall in North India. How? Because they obstruct the rain bearing winds and this causes heavy rainfall. So the Himalayan ranges causes heavy rainfall in North India. Then sixth question, how is the Northern Great Plain formed? Or the Northern Great Plain has heavy alluvial soil. Why? Because it is formed by depositional work of 3 river system. The Northern Great Plains formed by depositional work of 3 river system. One is the Sutlej River, second one is the Ganga River, and the third one is the Brahmaputra River. Understand? Then seventh question, the Northern Great Plain is suitable for the constructions of roads and railways. How? Answer, its level lands supports a network of roads and railways. Then eighth question, how is the peninsular plateau formed? Answer, The peninsular plateau formed by old racks. Keep it in mind. The peninsular plateau formed old racks. Then, ninth question. The peninsular plateau is suitable for agriculture. Why? Because, answer, it has influence on southwest monsoons and it is covered with black soil, which is useful for agriculture. So, that reason the peninsular plateau is suitable for agriculture. Understand? Then, 10th question. The eastern ghats are not continuous. Why? Answer, because the eastern ghats are separately from the rivers flowing towards east. So, that reason the eastern ghats are not continuous. Then, 11th question. Name the three parts of western coastal plain. One is, answer, one is the Konkan coast. Second one is the Karnataka coast. And the third one is Malabar coast. Then, 12th question. Name the two parts of eastern coastal plain. Very, very important. The two parts of eastern coastal plain. One is the Northern Sikkim and Coromandel coast. These are the two parts of eastern coastal plain. One is the Northern Sikkim and second one is Coromandel coast. Then, 13th question. The coastal plains of India are helped to foreign trade. How? Answer. The coastal plains of India provide some natural herbs which help in carrying on foreign trade. So, that reason the coastal plain of India are helped to foreign trade. Understand? Then, 14th question. The coastal plains of India are helped to tourism. How? Answer. The coastal plains of India are helped to tourism because many beaches are found along the coast and they attract tourist places. So, that reason the coastal plains of India are very helped to tourism. These are the 1 marks or 2 marks questions and answers in the lesson Indian Physiography. Now, let's move on the 3 marks question in this lesson. One is, what are the importance of physical division of India? Or, how are the physical divisions influence on a country? What are the importance of physical division of India? Answer. One is river system. Second one is climate. Third one is natural vegetation. Fourth one is land use. Fifth one is agriculture. Sixth one is transport. And the last one is distribution of population. These are the importance of physical divisions of India. Keep it in mind. Very, very important. Once again, I repeat the answer. The importance of physical divisions of India. One is river system, climate, natural vegetation, land use, agriculture, transport, and distribution of population. Then, second question. Name the 4 physical divisions of India. All of you know that. The 4 physical divisions of India. One is the Northern Mountain, second one is the Northern Great Plains, third one is the Peninsular Plateau, and the fourth one is the Coastal Plains and Islands. These are the 4 physical divisions of India. Then, third question, name the 3 parallel ranges of the Himalayas. Answer, the 3 parallel ranges of the Himalayas, one is the Greater Himalayas, second one is the Lesser Himalayas, and the third one is the Shivalik Hills. These are the 3 parallel ranges of the Himalayas. Then, let's move on. Fourth question, very, very important. Write a short note on the Greater Himalayas, or write a short note about the Greater Himalayas? Answer. First point. They are the innermost, continuous and highest ranges. The Greater Himalayas, it is the innermost, continuous and highest ranges. Then second point. The average height of the range is 6,100 meters. In the Greater Himalayas, the highest range, that is 6,100 meters. Then these ranges have many high peaks. Then fourth point, the Greater Himalayas are covered with snow throughout the year. Throughout the year, the Greater Himalayas are covered with the snow. Then fifth point, they are the home of many glaciers such as Gangotri and Yamunotri glaciers. Then last point, there are many passes such as Burzil, Luzila, etc. These are the Greater Himalayas. Very simple and very easy concept. And fifth question, this question is also very important. Keep it in mind. Write a short note about the Lesser Himalayas. Write a short note about the Lesser Himalayas. Answer. First point. These ranges are located to the south of the Greater Himalayas. Then second point. The Lesser Himalayas is also called as Himachal. Keep it in mind. Very, very important. The Lesser Himalayas is also called as Himachal. Then third point, they are 60 to 80 kilometers wide and 1500 to 4500 meters high. Then fourth point, there are many parallel ranges in the Lesser Himalayas. For example, Pripanjal, Musuri and Mahabharat. These are the many parallel ranges in the Lesser Himalayas. Then fifth point, they contain many valleys such as Kashmir Valley, Kangra Valley, Kullu Valley, etc. Then the last point, these are also noted for his hill stations, the hill stations such as Shimla, Ranikhet, etc. These are the Lesser Himalayas. Understand? Then sixth question, it is also very, very important. Write a short note about Shivalik Hills. Answer. First point, they are the lowest range of the Himalayas. Then second point, they are 600 to 1500 meters high. Then the Shivalik Hills, they extend from Jammu and Kashmir in the west to Arunachal Pradesh in the east. These are the Shivalik Hills. Then seventh question, what are dunes? Give example. Very, very important. Keep it in mind. What are dunes? What are dunes? And give example. Answer. Shivalik Hills have flat bottom structure valleys, that is called as dunes. It is a flat bottom structure valleys, that is called as a dunes. The best examples of the dune is Dehradun. Understand? Okay, my dear students, the remaining questions in this lesson we shall going to discuss the next classes or next video. Okay, dear students, in today's we have learned 1 marks question and answers, 2 marks question and answers and 3 marks question and answers in the lesson labor, and 1 marks question and answers and 2 marks question and answers and 3 marks question and answers in the lesson Indian physiography. The remaining questions
In this lesson, for 3 marks questions, we shall going to discuss the next video. Okay? Thank you.